Hello everybody, this is another Steam free-to-play review, and today we're focusing on Lights Out, which is a game that was made by college students in Quebec, Canada, and it is amazingly well done in my opinion. I'm just going to tell you that from the get-go. First, I want to go over the controls, so if you're playing this game, you won't be confused because it seems to like tell you how to use a controller, but it doesn't really do the same justice to the keyboard. So first off, your arrow keys are the movement, space bar is jump. A key is your laser slash bomb, and then shift is your transform from human to god form. 4 and 6 keys are for angling your bombs, but before you threw it, it took forever for me to figure this out. I struggled for a hot minute. It also moves your camera. D is your attack while you're in god form, and W is your dash. So the D and W don't have any like spells as you start out for your human form, but you will unlock some, so it will go into the respective slot that you can see in the top right to figure out what key you have to use. So I did collect all the fresco tablets in the game, and if you're interested in that, stay after the rating and I'll post and go through all the different fresco tablets and their stories. So I won't spoil anybody that's going to get them themselves, or if you're just interested in like reading the story, it'll be there for you. So this is a 2D platformer with stunning 3D character models and backdrops, which seem to only improve as the game goes on. And this is like an Aztec setting, it seems, where people are questioning the gods, and there's heretics, or they're the people that are like devout. And you can interact with these characters throughout the stages, and usually you're given two choices for every character. And some of these are kind of important because if you answer wrong, they won't let you access certain items like the fresco tablets. So you might have to replay this stage if you choose the wrong answer. I thought there was going to be like a dual ending kind of thing, since there's like so many two question things and like two choices that you can make throughout the game. But for my playthrough, I only saw one ending. So if there's something secret, I missed it. I tried multiple ways, but I got the same thing. So I think there's only one ending. So that was kind of a missed opportunity, but I still think the ending was really well done and the story's awesome. But what they do the best is the most important thing in a platformer. They give you like absolute control of your character, which is the most important thing. You can take out the graphics, you can take out the story, and still have a really good game if you have full control over your character. And to keep it interesting, they have like a bunch of mechanics that you can learn and use to conquer puzzles in many different ways, which is awesome. It keeps the game super interesting. Incoming hardcore cutscene. Pulls out his knife and says, "This is Mesopotamia!" So this cutscene's pretty important because you see Suna like questioning the gods again without like prompting from yourself. And that basically sets up the story for the game. That's the premise of the story, is like her trying to figure out if she wants to support the gods or back the people and kind of like turn her back to the gods. And this is the sun tablet, which you'll see is like, not a tablet, it's like a mirror, that you'll see is really important later on as the game goes on. Also in this cutscene, you get your awesome god powers, which you'll be using throughout the game to fight certain monsters. It's not as mobile as your human form, but you have to have it because in certain rooms it'll lock you in with the monsters and you have to kill them all before you can advance. So throughout the game, with most of the puzzles you face, you get to either choose if you want to use the god form or the human form. There's some parts, usually in like the tutorial when you get like a new power or something, that are required to use one of the parts, as you can see with like the three platform thing where I have to switch into human form to get past it. But throughout like the main part of the game, you basically get to choose how you want to solve the puzzles and choose which form you like the best, which is really neat. It gives you some replayability because it's not the same thing every time. You can figure out different ways to do things if you really want to. So this part, I was so freaking dumb. I didn't notice the first bomb actually opened the door, and I was just looking at it and I was trying to nail it with the bomb between the gap and the door and the like roof above it. And I literally spent like 12 minutes trying to throw a bomb in there to hit the thing like exactly dead on by adjusting the sights. I edited it out, but I just thought I should let you know so you don't make the same mistake. Make sure you watch, because it might not look like it hits the thing, but they give enough leeway that it doesn't glitch. So you might hit it and not recognize. Just look at the door before you just keep throwing bombs at it. So those big gems are really important because they're kind of like your checkpoints. So if you keep dying, it'll bring you back to there, which is really nice. Because if you had to restart the stage every time you died, you'd be in for a very long haul in this game. I died so many times. I could make like a 30-minute video of me just dying, like just a clip of me dying over and over again. So these arrows give you the free ability of flight, or they give you the free ability of not being able to jump depending on which way they're facing, but you can counteract them by changing your form. So one thing I will tell you that you don't have to worry about, since I played this game to the end, there's no puzzle that's unbeatable, but there are certain glitches that you run into. I ran into a few, and I'll show you them in the video, because they're pretty bad and they kind of affected the score a little bit because it just blew my mind. It took me by surprise anyways, not really blew my mind. I was just like, no, why did this happen? And I kid you not, when I downsorted here and I hit the thing and I fell through it and it said lights out like a loading screen, I literally thought I died. I was like, this is the most top 10 anime betrayal ever. Like, I had no idea. You told me to do this. Why did this happen? Oh, look, Mesopotamia Leonidas survived. Did you get god powers? No? That sucks. I got some god powers. The main objective of this game is to collect all the mirror pieces, which are in four different temple stages that have three fresco tablets in each. And then at the end of them is a bonus stage, which don't have a sun fragment in it, so you don't have to focus on beating them, but they each of the three bonus stages have one fresco tablet if you're planning on collecting all of them. So this opening area is called the hub, and this is the area that you have to explore to find all the temple areas and the bonus stages. You can't go to the bonus stage until you unlock it by doing the temple area first, though. So all the stage designs are pretty unique, like from the backdrops to the different obstacles you face, like these spinning wheels. I think they're only in this stage, which kind of keeps it very unique, so you're not just kind of doing the same thing over and over again, and it keeps adding more puzzles that you can face. And also keep a lookout for these hidden baldies, because they'll give you the two choices and then to like kind of represent the difference between the mortals and the gods and their viewpoints and whatnot, and they tell you more about Suna. Also, they hide some of the fresco tablets, so you need to talk to them if you want to collect all those. Also, watch out for spikes in this game. Spikes are the highest killing thing in this game, and sometimes their hitboxes are a little bit bigger than they should be. Not in the case of me running into them right here, because I was supposed to dash and I just didn't know that yet. But make sure you watch out for them. They are the highest killing thing besides jumping into a hole, for me anyway. This is approaching the first fresco tablet puzzle that I found in the game. And it kind of took me a little bit to figure out, because I was hitting them and they were going back off. So I was like, alright, if y'all want to just keep doing that. Suna uses flail wildly. It's super effective. I just started swinging it, I got it, but it took me a little bit to figure that out. And this is what a fresco tablet looks like, and that's part of the story. There's three fresco tablets for each story, so if you collect them all, you'll get the full storyline. And this is where you get your choice to level up a human or your divine side. And if you want more mobility, you'll usually pick the human one if you want a better fight, like this guy's telling you, Baldy, Ghost Baldy is telling you. It'll give you a better chance of fighting monsters, which is kind of useful because some of the monsters are really annoying and strong and do a lot of damage. So after you unlock a new ability, you'll always have a area right after it where you use that ability, like how there's this red area and I can run through it because that's the ability I unlocked. So it kind of shows you it before you actually have to face puzzles in the game. And this next area is uncanny. It's the first bonus stage that I've... This is the first time I got glitched and I hadn't saved yet, because there is no autosave. Always save your game in this, because I got stuck. And you can see that little bugger run into the wall because he's glitched too. Highly unfortunate. But yeah, I restarted, and at first I wasn't going to get all the fresco tablets, but I was like, if you take my progress, I'm going to take your secrets. This is the second time I got glitched. I got like a Spider-Man run up the wall kind of move, and I got stuck underneath the map, so I saved this time. So I just wanted to include this scene from near the end of the game, because it just shows how beautiful the settings are in this game. Lights Out is a great platforming game, so it gets a 7.5 out of 10, because things they mess up on is there's still some glitches in the game. They don't really tell you how to play with a keyboard, and it's kind of a short game still. There's only 3 hours of play for me to beat it two times, even though I was kind of going through it pretty quick. And that was with unlocking all the bonus things. It'd be really nice if they could add in achievements too. I love achievements in free-to-play games. But it was still a really great game. I definitely recommend you play it if you haven't already. As always, thanks for watching. If you could, please like and subscribe. And after this will be the tablets, the fresco tablets. Bye!